Hello student, welcome back to another session of electronics paper 1 applied electronics. So let us proceed. Student, we already started with chapter number 4 operational amplifiers. In last lecture we have seen the linear applications of op-amp. What were they? Non-inverting op-amp, inverting op-amp, buffer, inverter, adder and subtractor. So today we are going to see the nonlinear applications of op-amp. So let us proceed. Applications of op-amp. So let us see the applications of op-amp. The nonlinear applications. The circuit in which the shape of the output signal is different from the input are called as nonlinear circuits. So these are all nonlinear circuits. So in this video, what are the nonlinear applications? Integrator, differentiator, comparator and Schmitt trigger. We will see how to use the op-amp as integrator. Now, in the earlier video of the op-amp, we have seen use of op-amp as a summing amplifier and op-amp as a subtractor. And in this configuration, so far we have used resistor with the op-amp. So now suppose if we use the reactive element like capacitor or inductor along with the op-amp, then we can use this op-amp as integrator or differentiator. So in this video we will see how to use this op-amp as an integrator by using resistor and capacitor along with the op-amp. So we are going to see today the integrator, the nonlinear applications of op-amp, that is integrator. Operational amplifier as an integrator, the circuit diagram. See, I told you that always circuit diagram, one mark is reserved for circuit diagram and proper flow of the current and the parameters you have to show. So first of all, just look at this inverting op-amp configuration. And in this configuration, the feedback resistor RF, it was connected between the output terminal and the input inverting terminal. Now, suppose if we replace this feedback resistor by capacitor, then the same circuit can be used as an integrator. So now it is acting as an integrator. We have replaced the feedback resistor RF by the capacitor C. So let us understand how the circuit will act as an integrator. So in this circuit, let us assume that the current entering into the resistance RI is as let us it be II, and the current that is going out of this node is considered as IC or IF, that is flowing through the capacitor, that is the current flowing through the capacitor. As this capacitor is connected in the feedback, let us say this capacitor as C. So we call this capacitor as C. So now here, because of the feedback, this node will act as a node A, will act as a virtual ground, and so this node, at this node the potential will be equal to zero because the non-inverting terminal is grounded. So virtually the inverting terminal will be also, node A will be also will grounded, and the current II flows through the current capacitor IF, right? So here in this circuit the feedback resistance is replaced by the capacitor. The input signal is applied to the inverting terminal through input resistance RI. So VI is the input voltage applied to the inverting terminal through the resistance RI, and the current flowing through this resistance is II. The non-inverting terminal is grounded. Hence, the inverting terminal is virtual ground. So the potential equals to zero at the node A. Okay. So here, let VI be the input voltage applied to the non-inverting terminal through resistance RI. VO is the output voltage VA is the potential at point A. II is the current through the resistance RI. Then see here, what is that? II is equals to VR, the potential at the either side of the resistance RI. So VI minus VA upon the resistance RI. Equation 1. Due to virtual ground, the potential at node A, VA is equals to 0 because non-inverting terminal is grounded. So due to the virtual ground, VA is equals to 0. The equation 1 reduces to, what it reduces to? II is equals to VI upon RI. That is equation number 2. So the current is nothing but V, input current is equals to VI upon RI. Clear? So we got equation number 2. So the current flowing through this resistance II is equals to VI upon RI because the node A is at virtual ground. So voltage across the capacitor is given by VC is equals to the charge Q upon the capacitor C. But what is Q? Q is equals to integral I dt, or I is equals to dq upon dt. So Q charge is equals to the current into dt. So integration I dt. So what is here I? The current flowing through the capacitor is IF. So integral IF dt upon C. So VC. But V out is nothing but VC because VA is at 0, that is due to virtual ground. So V out is equals to minus integral IF dt upon C. But what is IF? IF is equals to II. And what is II? II is equals to the input current is equals to VI upon RI. So replacing IF by VI upon RI. So IF is equals to VI upon RI integration minus integration VI dt upon RIC. Thus the output voltage is proportional to the time integral of the input voltage, where R and C does not vary. We assume that the capacitor is not charging, and thus the amplitude of the output signal depends upon the value of RI and C. So this is the expression for the output voltage in terms of the input. So as you can see here, the output is the integration of the input. The output is the integration of the input. So using this circuit, we can integrate any input signal. So a negative sign indicates that output is out of phase with the input. So if we assume that the input voltage is a sine wave, so the input voltage is equals to V sine omega t. So substituting in the equation, V out is equals to minus integral V sine omega t dt RI upon C. So V constant, so sine omega t dt integration sine omega t dt, the integration of sine omega t is minus cos omega t, and C plus C, that is C is a constant of integration. So minus V minus cos omega t upon RI C to cos omega t integration is omega. So RIC omega minus minus plus, so V omega t RIC omega plus C. Okay, so this is nothing. This equation indicates that the frequency increases, the output decreases. Hence, the frequency signals can pass through more easily than the higher frequency signal. Therefore, this integrator is also called as low pass filter. It is also called as low pass filter. So output waveform for different input to the op-amp integrator. So if you apply this, so what will be the output signal? Suppose if you apply a DC signal at the input, then the output will get this signal. So as you can see its initial output will increase in a negative direction, right? It will increase in the negative direction, and at the certain point the output will be saturated. So for DC you will get this output, right? Similarly, if you apply a sinusoidal wave at the input, that is sine omega t, then the output we will get is cos signal cosine signal, that is cos omega t. And likewise, if you apply the square wave at the input, then at the output you will get an triangular wave. So at the output you will get the triangular wave. Okay, triangular wave. Now here the amplitude of the output depends upon the value of R and C. So far we have seen the simple integrated circuit, and we understood that using the this circuit we can integrate any input signal. But in real life, if you use this integrator, then you may not get the desired output, which you should get using theoretical calculation. Okay, so we'll see the limitations of, let us understand the limitation of simple integrated circuit. So when we apply a DC, this is the output, and when we apply a square wave, we get a triangular wave or rectangular pulses. We get a ramp, that is the decreasing in the negative direction. Clear? So let us see the uses of op-amp integrator. By choosing 1 upon RC larger than unity, the integrator with amplification is possible. So if we choose the value of 1 upon RC factor larger than unity, more than 1, then the integrator can be used along with the amplification. So let us see some uses of it. It is used as a low pass filter, right? For constant DC input, a linearizing ramp signal is obtained at the output, as you are seeing in the waveform, right? This is useful in the circuit like A to D converter or digital voltmeter, etc. So when we are going to see A to D converter, we'll see how we get a linearizing ramp. Okay, adding the integrator circuit can be constructed for various input signal. So these are the some of the applications of uses of integrator. So limitations of op-amp integrator. If the input offset error voltage exists, then this voltage gets added in the process of integration and giving rise to an error at the output. Some portion of the input bias current also flow through capacitor and charge it continuously, and hence the output voltage goes on increasing with the time. If the integration time is large enough, then the charge on the capacitor leakages and through the dielectric, and the voltage of the capacitor will not be held constant during this interval. So the output decreases at higher frequency. So these are the limitations of the op-amp integrator. Okay, student, if the problem comes, it comes for 3 marks. So based on the formula, let us see the problem based on your op-amp as integrator. So here, find out the voltage of an op-amp, output voltage of an op-amp integrator after 0.5 second and 3 seconds. So you are given time 0.5 seconds and 3 seconds. If R is equals to 100 kilo ohm, so 100 kilo ohm is 100 into 10 raised to 3 ohms, and capacitor is equals to 1 microfarad, micro 10 raised to minus 6, so 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 farad. Input voltage is equals to 2 volt DC, and a dual power supply of 15 volt is used. So here dual power supply is also given to you. You are given the value of R, C, input voltage and time. So let us find out the output voltage of an op-amp integrator. Solution: for op-amp integrator, the output voltage or output expression is given by minus integral Vi dt upon RC. With a constant input voltage, Vo is equals to minus Vi t upon RC. Okay, so we'll substitute the value of t first for 0.5 second and then for 3 second, and we will find out the output voltage. So with the constant input voltage, VO is equals to minus VIT upon RC. So after 0.5 second, we'll find the output voltage. So output voltage is equals to minus VI is 2 volt, 2 into T is 0.5. R is 100 kilo ohm. So 100 into 10 raised to 3. And C was equals to 1 microfarad. So that is 10 raised to minus 6. So minus 6, 3, 4, 5. So it will be how much point? 10 raised to minus 1. So it comes out to be V out is equals to minus 10 volt. Okay. So it is minus 10 volt after 0.5 second. So after 3 seconds, let us find out. So V out is equals to minus 2. Now we are taken T as 3 seconds. So 3 upon 100 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to minus 6. So it is 6 upon 10 raised to minus 1. So it is coming out to be V out is equals to minus 60 volt, but this is not possible 60 volt after 6 by because this output is not possible because you are given the dual power supply equal to plus minus Vsat is equals to plus minus 15 minus 2, that is 13. It can go, output can maximum go to 13 volts. So after 3 second, your output will not show 60 volt, but it will show 13 volt only. Is it clear? So they have given you the dual power supply was applied, was a maximum biasing voltage that is applied to the op amp is 15 volt plus minus 2 volt. So the output saturation voltage is nothing but 13 volt. So output, even though the output is coming out to be 60 volt, but practically you'll get the 13 volt only. Clear? So this was the problem. This type of problem can come in the exam. So student, in today's session we have seen the op amp as an integrator where the output was different from the input, that is in the non-linear application. In the linear application, we get the output waveform shape same as the input, only the output waveform is amplified. But in non-linear application, the input shape or the output shape is different from that of the input shape, so they are called as non-linear application. So today we have seen the integrator circuit where the feedback, in the feedback we have applied the capacitor instead of the resistor, and we got the output V out is equals to minus integral VI dt upon R and C. And we have seen that how when we apply a sinusoidal wave, how the output is the inversely proportional to the frequency. So at higher frequency, we will not get the proper integration, right? So here, in the exam, the question may come as state, explain the working of an integrator using op-amp and state the uses and limitations of the integrator, right? So we have seen the limitations and we have seen the uses of integrator, right, student? So here we came to the end of operational amplifier session 4. So today we have seen one of the application of non-linear application, that is integrator. In the next session we'll be seeing the another applications of op-amp, that is non-linear applications of op-amp, that is differentiator followed by comparator and Schmitt trigger. All these are non-linear applications of op-amp. Okay, thank you, students.